Now we're ready to execute our cycle count. This can be done either through automatic scheduling or through a manual scheduling process. Manual schedules can be done in addition to automatic scheduling, but it's not typical. Most of the time you're going to use an automatic schedule. The next step that we want to perform is our cycle count request in the print of the cycle count listing. This listing is what the stock clerk uses to perform the actual counts out on the production floor. To perform our cycle count, the first thing we have to ensure is that our cycle count is scheduled. So if you go to the Tools menu and go to Cycle Count Scheduler and then press the OK button, this will send a concurrent request to be submitted to schedule our cycle counts. We're going to check on this just to make sure it's completed, and it is. Now we're ready to perform a full cycle count. To do this, we go to our Tools menu, Perform Full Cycle Count. Go to the Parameters screen, put in our cycle count. Go to the next parameter screen, put in our cycle count. The next one as well. We want to save our output so that we can go back and see our listings. Also, I want to note, if you did decide to change your mind and display your on-hand quantities, you could change this setting here. If you go to the Options button, you can set your printer. Your printer, in this case, needs to be a printer that you would want the cycle count listings printed to on a daily or weekly basis, depending on how your cycle counts were set up. You'll definitely want to set the copies to 1 and choose a valid printer. Once you've made all these settings, you can submit the program. Kicks off a concurrent request. You can go and view those requests. Depending on your system and the number of items, this can take a bit of time. This one's completed. And if we want to view our cycle count listing, we can click the View Output button. And here's the listing as it would be printed for the inventory clerk to perform cycle counts.